Welcome to the Gene Center of the Ludwig Maximilians University of Munich. My name is Karl-Peter Hopfner and my research group studies the molecular and structural mechanisms of cellular stress responses such as DNA repair and innate immunity. The Gene Center is an interdisciplinary research institute located at the high-tech campus of the University of Munich. We are just outside the city center of Munich and near the beautiful Bavarian Alps and Upper Bavarian Lake Country. We present our newest results on the structure and mechanism of the Rod50 NMR11 complex in sensing DNA double strand breaks, which are published in this issue of Cell. Breaks in chromosomes can be induced by a variety of endogenous and environmental influences. An important question in the field is how DNA breaks are recognized, how they are prepared and repaired. A first step in this process is the recognition and processing of DNA ends by the complex between the nuclease MR11 and the ATPase Rod50. We set out to derive a structural framework for the complex between MR11 and Rod50, and this was achieved by Dirk Bemeleit, a PhD student in the group, and Katja Lammens, a staff scientist.
And we were able to record X-ray diffraction data, and these data were used to calculate electron density maps and an atomic model of the protein complex. And this model led us to some quite big surprises of the protein structure.
The structure is a surprisingly open complex with a central MR11 nuclease dimer and two widely separated Rod50 ATPase domains. The open access to the MR11 active site nicely explains how this complex can bind even obstructed DNA ends.
From previous work by us and others, we knew that Rod50s form tightly engaged dimers in the presence of ATP. In fact, Karin Merkel, a PhD student in the group, could crystallize Rod50 in complex with both the C-terminal helix-loop-helix domain of MR11 and with ATP. She found that ATP binding not only engages the ATPase domains, but also lead to a rotation of the coiled coil domains. Karina wanted to see whether Rod50 also engages within the MR11 Rod50 complex.
And to test this, we first used cross-linking analysis. I engineered cysteine residues into the protein and probed the conformation by site-specific cross-linking. These results show that while the Rod50 ATPase domains are far apart in the absence of ATP, they come close together in the presence of ATP and even more so in the presence of ATP and DNA. ATP also increases the DNA and hairpin binding efficiency of the complex and has an impact on the MR11 structure.
To learn more about the closed DNA binding form of the complex, we again use the technique of small angle X-ray scattering. But the data analysis was quite complex. However, with the help of Johannes Söding, another group leader at the Gene Center, we could computationally separate both conformations and provide a first model of the closed DNA binding form.
So what can we conclude? Our structure suggests that the ATP binding domains of Rod50 undergo a large conformational change, much like a molecular clamp. The DNA binding results indicate that this clamp-like movement induces a conformation that binds DNA. One likely model is that it functions similar to a hand grabbing a piece of rope. The open hand would be the loading conformation, the closed hand would be the DNA binding conformation. The arms attached to the hands might be the coiled coils of Rod50 and can tether DNA ends to each other or to the sister chromatid.
Thus, the MR11 complex is a molecular clamp in DNA repair, so we hope you will enjoy reading our paper.